But woe to that man, the man who would betray the Son of Man. Very serious words coming from Scripture here. The literal words of the Lord Jesus Christ himself. And he's saying that this man is going to involve himself into an eternal realm where literally he's going to be violating the very plan of God in his attempt to overthrow the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I mean, what Jesus is identifying here will have tremendous consequences. And of course, there came that time when Judas saw, he finally saw it. And when he did, he was so ashamed and he could not even stand to live with himself. And he literally took his own life. Well, if we could just fast forward this for a few minutes and make this same application to so many people that you know and I know. They're moving fast forward through life with no thought or consequences of what's going to be ahead of them when they just totally abandon anything that's spiritual. Anything that has to do with God, has to do with Jesus, has to do with the Holy Spirit, totally reject it. Nothing to it. No consequences to be paid. And I look at that and I say, well, I'm so saddened by that. My heart grieves because I know people, you know people, they're going to end up in hell because they have no regard to their own spiritual self, not to speak of God as a spirit. And Judas, even though he had been living with Jesus and traveling with Jesus and listening to all those tremendous sermons and seeing all of those miracles, he chose tangible things of the world over the spiritual things. I mean, truly, that is reality. And again, we see this played out in people that they're just so caught up in everything that represents power and money, fame, and they're willing to sacrifice everything to obtain it, even though they're not going to be able to keep it. And the thing is, it just doesn't occur to people. And you say, well, Pastor King, why is that? It's because they have not truly experienced the opening of their spiritual eyes and the true born-again experience. And everything about their life is carnal. They live in a carnal realm. They think in the carnal realm. They act in the carnal realm. And Judas gives us the picture. And Jesus is identifying. He says, woe is that man who would betray the Son of Man. Pastor Jack King with the gospel on the radio broadcast.